Hello friends, myself Akansha Mishra. Now I'm going to tell you about bones and muscles. Friends, can you feel something hard below the skin? These are the bones that are present under our skin. Friends, our bone and our body is just like a hanger and a shirt. On hanger, the shirt hangs. In the same way, on bones we hangs, means our body hangs. Friends, now I will tell you about skeleton. Skeleton is the framework of the bones that give shapes and support to our body and protect our soft, delicate inner organs. Friends, now I will tell you about bones. Friends, do you know a human adult have 206 bones and human child have more than 350 bones? Friends, you are thinking that why the small child have more than 350 bones? Why the adult have 206 bones? I will tell you. First, I will tell you about children's. Why they have 350 bones? Friends, have you ever noticed when the baby come out from her mother's stomach, then it's look like a very cute baby and its fingers very small, leg is also small. It's look very pretty. And friends, that is why the bones are joints and it can't work. When it grow up, the child growing, that time the bones are joining to each other. And when the child become the age of 9 or 10, at that time also the fully bones are not mixed to each other. Friends, when the baby become or no, when he become an adult person or the age of 20 or more than 20 age, at that time their bones are joints. And friends, do you know why the age of 30 person, what they do if they fall, so their bones will broke? And the doctor advised them that eat calciums, vitamins, phosphorus, etc. Friends, why he told you no? Because the people, when they becoming adult, and at that time they don't used to like eating vitamins, calciums, phosphorus. And friends, do you know a small child and his or her mother, what they do that force in the baby that you have to eat vitamins, calciums, phosphorus, etc. Then only the bones of child is very strong. When it will fall or the bones will broke, then it can be joined easily. But if the elder ones, those who are adult, those who are the age of more than 30 age, if they will fall, their joints will very hard to, their bones will not join easily. Then the doctor advised them eat calcium, vitamins, phosphorus, etc. Friends, do you know if you don't like the tablets or what, or any some vegetables, you can drink the juice. Friends, one thing more is there, that if you are going in shops and if they are giving you packed juice, that is not good for our health or for our bones, because in that some chemicals also are mixed. You can go for a shops and where they are making from their hand, and in front of you, you can tell that you make the juice and at that time you can drink, or you can take the fruits at your home and you can make the juice. That is good for our health and for us also. And that can, or adult persons can drink, or a small person can drink. Friends, now I will tell you about skull. The hard bony structure is protected by the brain. It's protect the brain. Means these are the inside the skin, that is skull, and it protects our brain and it gives the shape of head. And friends, in a normal person, adult person, have 22 bones in skull. And in the lower jaw, which we can, it is movable jaw, in which we can talk, eat, etc. Friends, now I will tell you about rib cage. Friends, the rib is a, it looks like a narrow cage. In that only the heart and lungs is saved. If suppose in any person is beating, at that time here only the heart will save with the help of ribs. Friends, there are two pairs, and one is 12 and another side is 12. 12 plus 12 is equal to 24. 24 bones are there in ribs, in rib cage. There are two floating ribs, and in that we can count it 12. 12 here, 12 one pairs and second pair is 12. 12 is equal to 12 plus 12 is equal to 24. Friends, now I will tell you about backbones, or it known as a spine. Friends, backbone is known as spine or a vertical column. Friends, now I will tell you, in backbones there are 33 bones, and it helps us to bend, or we can walk, we can rest our backbones. It helps us. And friends, now I will tell you about joints. Friends, joints are which that the bones, two bones meet together, is called joint. Friends, do you know there are two types of joints? They are immovable joints and movable joints. First, I will tell you about movable joints. Immovable joints are hinge joint, ball and socket joint, pivot joint and gliding joint. And I will tell you about immovable joint. Immovable joint, it's coming bone of skull, and the long bones, it is immovable joints, and it can't work. The large bones can't work. And now friends, I will tell you about muscles. Friends, muscles are lie under the skin, and there are three types of muscles. I will tell you, first is involuntary muscles, second voluntary muscles and cardiac muscles. Friends, you are thinking that in previous chapter I have told you about involuntary action and voluntary action. Those are the actions, and these are the muscles. And these are the involuntary muscles and voluntary muscles. I will tell you specially. Involuntary muscles are those muscles that are not under our control. Means, just like our stomach, intestine, etc. Now I will tell you about voluntary muscles. Voluntary muscles are those muscles, those who are under our control. Means arm, hand, leg, etc. Friends, now I will tell you about cardiac muscles. Cardiac muscles are present in our heart, and it works involuntary muscles. And it helps us, and it works throughout our life. Friends, do you know it never stop or it never tired also? Friends, at the end of this chapter, I want to give you some points. Friends, do you know what is the study of bone is called? The study of bone is called osteology. Friends, now I will tell you what is vertebrates and what is invertebrates. Vertebrates means animals such as cheetah, tiger or a snake have a backbone is called, those animals have a backbone is called vertebrates. And now I will tell you about invertebrates. Invertebrates and animals such as earthworm, caterpillar and cockroach, etc. They do not have backbones. So that is why they call invertebrates. Friends, today I am standing here on the behalf of Kids Motivation Channel. If this video is informative for you, then you can like, share, subscribe and comment us. Thank you. Bye-bye. Friends, don't go away. I will tell you first our brain. Brain is the control center of our body, and its parts are cerebellum, and medulla. If you want more information about its parts, cerebellum, and medulla, you can see my previous video about brain. Thank you. Bye-bye.